Randall Baxter.
I'm gearing up for the Melbourne Cup there, fellas. I ain't no mood for no interviews today.
Oh, get in the mood.
Remember Sonny Sandoval?
Yeah, I heard about that. That's a terrible thing.
I understand you buried a few of your horses back there.
Well, sometimes horses have to be put down.
How about jockeys?
No, hold on here. Why would I want to get rid of Sonny? He was one of my best.
Well, the way we heard, he was losing more than he was winning. Guaranteed contract was costing you major moolah.
Sonny was a champion, you know. You can't teach that. He still had the ability to pull it out if he just had his head on straight.
Saying it wasn't?
He started losing focus, you know, and his sense of priorities were whacked out.
Why is that?
Why else? He started listening to a woman. Should have never hired that female trainer. Bad luck.
Told him, go to hell. Won over 100 races since then, and can still dance the Arabe Tapatio with the best of them, huh?
Hey, it's Baxter. How'd your money?
Send that tab over to my table, if you will, partner. Let's cut him off. He's got to make weight, and these beers ain't helping.
I'll take care of the tab, Chris.
And another round for everyone.
You forget who owns you, Sonny.
Don't have a problem when I'm winning.
But you're not. So I suggest you better turn it around before you have a problem that can't be fixed.
That was the beginning of the end. He lost his competitive edge. That old girl filled his head with all kind of ideas about how horses should be eating organic hay and drinking room temperature water.
Oh, horror. Lady Macbeth got a name?
Yeah, Christy Duren. She made him soft. It's the last thing a jockey can be.
Sounds like she wasn't just grooming the horses.
Yeah, last I heard, she moved in with him. I fired her ass a day too late, if you ask me.